Good evening. Hi, Natalie.
Hi, teacher.
How are you?
Fine, and you?
Sleepy. I want to sleep. Hi, Felicita. Good evening.
Hi. Good evening.
Alonso and everybody is getting online. Okay, I'm gonna take attendance. All right, I'm gonna check the list because remember that we have to begin at eight. I'm sorry. And let me see. Today we have the sessions. Give me a second because I haven't received the message. We didn't receive any message today, right?
Good evening.
Hi, good evening, Javier.
Teacher.
Yes?
Usted continuará en el segundo bloque con nosotros.
No sé, fíjese.
Ah, de verdad.
I don't know, Felicita.
Oh,
somebody
vamos a solicitar.
Ah, thank you so much. Sorry, Natalie.
Son varios grupos, ¿verdad? ¿Qué hay?
Mm-hmm. We have some groups. Estoy preguntando cómo quedó ahora la sesión de refuerzo. ¿No les han mandado a ustedes el horario?
No.
Ah, vaya, lo vamos a pedir entonces. Okay, well, I'm gonna take attendance today, right now. I'm sorry. Soy la Noemi Córdoba, no, not here yet. Jonathan Adonai Cruz has never been present. Carla Noemi?
Present.
Salazar, all right. Carlos Alberto Bautista?
Present.
Yeah, thank you. Yesenia Lourdes, not here. Jorge Alexander, not here. I'm going to mention the ones that are here. Grecia Yulisa Pereira.
Present.
Felicita Cruz.
Present.
Okay. Alonso Antonio Turcio Brizuela.
Present.
Francisco Javier Villatoro Canales.
Present.
Andrea Natalie Espinal Umanzor.
Present.
Helen María Chávez Quintanilla. Helen María. Oh, all right, very good, okay. So I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, so we're gonna begin today with class number 18. Okay, so two more, sorry, I didn't change this number. So two more classes. And we finish the módulo, all right? We finish módulo or course number one. Okay, so today we're gonna go to class number 18. And today we will talk about locations and to give direct directions, all right? All right, so right now to begin, we're gonna brainstorm some vocabulary, okay? I want you to tell me any word that you want, okay? I'm gonna make a list of words because we will use them. Okay, so Grecia, can you please tell me two words? Any word that you want. But, two words. Sorry, yes. But they have to be objects, places, whatever, except adjective or verb, okay? For example, I can tell you door, chair. All right, those would be my words. Can you tell me more words, please? Okay, Gracia, can you give me some words?
Okay, windows.
Okay, windows. What else?
Mirror.
Mirrors, all right. We can find these objects in the house. Okay, very good. What else? Tell me one more. And after that, Natalie, you will tell me three words. Pencil. Sorry, Natalie.
Pencil.
Okay, pencils. All right. What else?
Notebook.
Notebooks. All right. What else? You can, everybody can participate also. All right. You can participate. Carlos?
Yes. Desk.
Okay. Desks. All right. Desks. What else?
Table.
Lobby.
Table.
Tables. Yeah.
Newspaper.
Shades.
Newspapers. All right. Yes. Sorry?
Money.
Sorry. Natalie, what do you say?
Shoes.
Oh, shoes. Okay, shoes. Yeah?
How do you say mesa de comedor?
Oh, that is a dining table.
Dining table.
Dining table. Dining yes. Table. Sorry. Let me see. Antonio said money, right?
Yes.
Voy a escribir esa palabra en rojo. Después le voy a decir por qué. All right, money. What else? Let's continue. Tell me more words.
Floor.
Flowers or what?
Floor.
Oh, floors. Okay, very good. Floors. What else?
Curtains.
Curtains. Okay, curtains. What else?
Chairs.
Yes, we have chairs.
Sure.
Washer.
Closet.
Sorry, Carlos.
Washer.
Lavadora.
Yes.
Okay, so it's washing machines, all right? Or washing machine in singular. Yeah, what else?
Microwave.
Microwave, very good. The microwave oven, el microondas, right? Microwave oven. What else?
Sofa. Cabinet.
Sofa, very good. Sofa,
cabinets.
Yeah, what else?
Computer.
TV. Very good. TV. What else?
Telephone.
Kitchen. El cuarto, right? This is the room. El objeto AC. Se llama stove.
AC.
All right. Very good. Okay. AC. What else?
A Mac.
Picture. Very good. Picture. Amaca is hammock. All right. Hammock.
Oh, okay.
Summer, spring.
No. Summer, spring, no. We cannot okay. use them. I will tell you later why. Lo que estamos haciendo es recolectando vocabulario, or we are collecting vocabulary to use with there is and there are. Yeah, and if we say spring, summer, I think that in the context, we're not going to use them. All right. Okay, what else?
La nevera, no sé.
Oh, okay. We're gonna make it short.
Fridge.
Yeah, that's the short way. What else?
Hairdresser.
What do you mean? What do you mean, Antonio? Hairdresser.
Peluquero.
Ah, okay, but no, because
no.
I need only names from objects.
Ah, object.
Or places, if you want, or places. For example.
Hello.
Cinema.
Hello.
Book.
Grecia, what's the meaning of that?
Almohada. Pillow.
Okay, a pillow. All right. Pillow. What else?
Pillow. Okay.
What else can you tell me?
Refrigerator.
We have fridge.
Fridge.
Okay.
Box. Beds, okay, very good. Beds.
Garden.
Garden, excellent.
Bottle.
Bottles.
Botella.
Uh-huh, all right, Botella. Bottles. Okay, what else?
Garage.
Yes.
Paper.
Sorry, someone mentioned Pedro.
Glasses,
very good. Glasses can be vasos or they can be copas, right?
Ah,
yeah,
okay.
they can be two things. Okay, what else?
Face mask.
Paper.
Basement, you said, Javier?
Face mask. Face mask.
Face mask.
Yep, mascarilla.
Okay, ah, yeah. I was like, okay, face mask. Okay, entré en un lapsus. Se me deslizó el hamster. Okay, let me see. Carpet. Así digo yo cuando se me va la onda. Se me deslizó el hamster. Okay, so carpet, what else?
Toilet.
Oh, the toilet. Javier?
Up.
Bedroom.
No, I don't understand, Javier. Can you spell it, please?
C-U-P.
Cell phone.
A puppy.
C-U-P.
Oh, a cup. All right. Very good.
Cell phone.
In plural, cups. Cell phone. What else?
Stereo.
Sorry?
Stereo.
Oh, stereo. Yeah.
Microphone.
Oh, a microphone.
Microphone.
Dogs, speaker. Cats, yeah?
Speaker. A speaker.
Ah, speaker.
A sticker.
All right, very good. A sticker too. Okay, very good. Sticker. What else?
Receipt.
Okay, what else?
Bags.
Do we have closet?
Glasses.
Yeah, we have glasses. We have glasses, we have closets.
Bottles.
Bags.
Bottles, bags.
Box.
Boxes.
Yep.
Okay, boxes.
Battery.
Battery.
Flowers.
Umbrella.
Flowers. Umbrella.
Wallet.
Wallets.
Camera.
Camera. Okay, we're gonna write only those words. So listen right now what we're gonna do. Now, if you pay attention, all the words are in black color except money. So I'm gonna explain something to you. A little quickly, because you need to know this. In English, we have countable and uncountable words, okay? Countable words are the ones you can count, and the uncountable words are the ones that you can't count, all right? Very good. So countable words, you can count. The words, and uncountable words you can't count. So if you pay attention here, all the words that we have here except money, we can count with them. For example, I can say one door, two doors, one chair, two chairs, one sofa, two sofas, one toilet, two toilets, one kitchen, two kitchens, one bed, two beds. I can say everything, okay? I can count with that. But with money, no. But you can say, teacher, pero el dinero sí lo podemos contar. Los billetes sí, pero la palabra dinero, no. It is not possible in English to say one money, two monies, no, right? Is it clear?
Clear.
So for that reason, cuando usted vaya a usar there is or there are with an uncountable word, always, always is gonna be plural, sorry, singular. There is money. Y no vamos a usar a, and we're not gonna use an. Entonces les voy a poner aquí, with uncountable words, it is not possible to use a or an. Only when the word is singular and you can count. For example, if I say, there is a TV, it's possible because you can count TVs. Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes.
All right, so you can say there is a TV. Y ahora si lo quiero decir en plural, digo, there are two TVs, three TVs, etc., televisions, etc., right? Very good. But when it is an uncountable noun, it is not possible. So if I want to say in English, hay agua, how do I say that? ¿Podemos contar el agua? Can we count water?
No.
No.
It is not possible to say one water, two waters, three waters in English. No. So that's why we're going to say there is or there are?
There is.
Very good. That is the reason why money is in red color, because money is uncountable, not possible to count. Is it clear?
Clear.
But with all the other words, you can say there is a door, there are doors. There is a mirror, there are mirrors. There is a telephone, there are telephones. And the word is going to be plural. There is a battery, there are batteries. Is it clear?
Clear.
So listen what you're gonna do right now. You will think about your house and I want you to give me examples. No quiero que los escribas, si usted quiere escribirlos, good. But I need this activity to be more speaking. So what I need is I need you to take a picture from this and I want you to say examples about your house. Remember, if you use there are, la palabra que sigue tiene que estar en plural. There are a lot of, for example, in my house, there are a lot of plants because my mother loves plants. So in my house, there are a lot of plants, there are a lot of flowers, there is a tree. In my house, there is a dog, there is a parrot, there are three televisions. There is a home theater. There, blah, 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 blah. Is it clear? Okay, so do you have the picture?
Yes. Yeah.
Excellent, very good. So we're gonna go and we're gonna practice. All right, so let's see. I'm gonna make some groups. All right, I'm gonna make some groups. One group is gonna be.
Good night, teacher.
Hi, Tito. Good evening. How are you?
Good evening. How are you?
Fine. I'm fine. I'm happy. Okay. I'm happy and ready to begin. Okay. Remember, it doesn't matter if you don't write anything. I need this activity to be speaking only. All right. So I'm gonna give you some minutes and bye bye. Go to your groups and accept the invitation, please. I'm gonna move Tito to another group.
Teacher.
You didn't receive the invitation.
Sí, pero toqué afuera y ya no me dejó ver.
Ah, okay. So I'm gonna move you to room breakout room number two. Okay.
Thank you.
All right. All right. Good. Oh, this is going to be a very interesting practice because both of you are very, very fast, okay? Now you, okay. You can speak a lot, all right? Go ahead. Remember, when you use singular, try to remember a or an, and if it is there are, the plural word, okay?
Okay.
All right, go ahead. Good.
Nada más. There is a laptop.
There is a laptop. Uh-huh.
And when you participate and say your sentences, you can say in my house and you begin, okay?
Ah, okay.
All right, good.
Thank you, teacher.
Yes, yeah. All right. In my house there is a laptop.
Exactly. In my house there is a laptop, there are two sofas, there are three dogs, there are five cats.
Okay.
There are two lions, whatever you want. All right?
Okay.
Good.
Thank you.
There is TV, como dijo, a lot of shoes,
a lot of qué?
Shoes, zapatos.
Ah, excellent, there are a lot of shoes.
There are two windows. There are four chairs.
Yeah.
There is a hammock. There. Alguien más, please.
Bueno, voy a continuar yo para que me corrijan.
Okay, go ahead.
There are sofa.
Oh, okay. There are sofa or there is a sofa.
There are.
Ah, va, entonces tiene que mencionar el número y la palabra plural, sofas.
Okay. There are two sofas.
Excellent. When you use there are, you need to mention the word in plural. Okay, go ahead.
Okay. There are chairs.
Uh-huh.
There is TV.
A TV.
There is a TV.
Excellent. Very good. There is a TV.
There is a dog.
Okay.
There is a table.
Uh-huh.
There a lot of shoes.
There are
a lot of shoes.
Excellent, very good. There are a lot of shoes.
There are two curtains.
Okay. Repeat, please.
There are two curtains.
Okay. Vamos a tratar de no decir a cuando usemos there are. Okay.
Okay. Okay.
Because a is for singular.
Okay. There are two curtains.
Excellent. Very good. There are two curtains. Excellent.
Noemí, su tiempo.
Okay. There are one table and six chairs.
Oh, there is one table and six chairs. Aunque mencione six chairs, pero como la primera fue table, we use there is. Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Okay.
There are three sofas. There is a fan, ventilador.
Sí. Oh, there is a fan.
A fan. There are many windows.
Okay.
There are a lot of toys. There are table, outdoor. There are six doors.
Okay, did you finish, everybody? Okay, so all right. So I would like to listen to your sentences, pero les quiero pedir permiso para algo, ¿okay? Voy a poner la pizarra virtual y si yo escucho que hay un errorcito por ahí, lo voy a escribir. ¿Les parece?
Okay.
I am telling you because no quiero que se me vaya a poner nerviosa si me mira escribiendo. No, esto es para aprender. All right, this is for learning.
Okay.
Or you say, oh my God, I'm saying it incorrect. Okay, because we're gonna learn to say it correct. All right, so I'm gonna. All right. Okay, so a volunteer, maybe Gracia can help me. All right, Gracia, go ahead. Tell me what things. Tell me some sentences that you said.
Okay, Miss. Pero no tengo la pantalla con las palabras. Sorry. One moment, please.
Okay, okay.
Okay. There are doors.
Okay.
There are chairs. There are windows. There are mirrors. There are pencils. There are notebooks.
Notebooks. Mm-hmm.
There are desks. There are tables.
Okay.
There are newspapers.
Mm-hmm.
There are shoes. There is dining table. There is money. There are floors. There are curtains.
Okay, thank you. Thank you very much, Grecia. Excellent. Very good. Now, Grecia, or maybe another person can help me. Number one, okay. What is the problem with number one?
Singular.
Singular. And we need?
Plural.
Plural, all right. So, maybe, but yo creo que Grecia sí estaba pensando en el plural. El problema fue la pronunciation. Okay? So, okay. this one is a little difficult. It is a difficult word to pronounce. So you say desks. La pronuncia normal, desk, y le agrega inmediatamente el sonido s. Sería desks.
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 Okay.
All right, desks. Okay, what about in number two? What is the problem with number two? Mm-hmm. Something is missing.
Hey.
Algo le falta.
Hey.
Yes. This one, all right?
Oh, okay.
Why? Because dining table is something that you can count, is singular. Now, number three is correct, okay? Number three is correct. It is correct. But I want you to see the difference, okay? When we have a word that we can count in singular, we're gonna say a or an. But if we have a word that is uncountable, that it is not possible to count, we are not gonna use a or an. Is it clear?
Yeah.
Okay, excellent, excellent. Okay, Carlos, can you give me some examples, please?
Floors.
Okay.
There are floors.
Okay, what else?
There are curtains.
Okay.
There are closets.
Okay.
There is a washing machine.
Okay.
There is a microwave oven.
Okay, and one more.
There is sofa.
Oh my God. In the last one we slept. Carlos, what is missing?
Ah.
Excellent, very good. There is a sofa because we can count sofas, all right? Nice, Carlos. Okay. Tito, help me, please.
Teacher.
Okay, Carlos, yeah?
I need to understand this topic. Okay. When it's singular and if a countable word, always put a.
Or an.
Or an.
Mm-hmm. It depends the beginning of the word. For example, if it is a consonant, it's a. And if it is a vowel, it's an. Mm-hmm.
In plural, no.
No.
Only in plural, singular.
Only in singular with countable words, okay?
For we say uno.
Exactly,
one.
Exactly. I'm an, the meaning is one. So if you say, for example, I have a TV, you are saying I have one TV. Is it clear?
Yes, if we have many sofa, for example, I okay. have 10 sofa, the expression changed to there are 10 sofa.
Sofas.
Sofas.
Or there are, if you don't want to say I have 10 sofas, but 10 sofas in one house, it is a lot. So you can say there are a lot of sofas and you don't mention the number.
Okay.
Is it clear?
Sure. Okay. Yes.
Sure. Yes, Pedro?
Yes. Yo he entendido que sofá es el más largo. Los demás los que son sillones.
Armchairs.
Uh-huh. Entonces, esos... porque hicimos nosotros esa oración y lo dejamos como there is sofa.
Ajá, uh-huh. There is a sofa.
Uh-huh.
Ya, yeah, los, okay. los chiquititos se llaman armchairs, los dos que acompañan.
¿Lo puede escribir, please?
Ahí está en la pizarra virtual. Yes, here. Armchairs. Armchairs. Because, yeah, los silloncitos chiquitos, los que nosotros decimos sillones pequeños, right?
There are two armchairs.
Exactly.
Hombros.
Brazos.
O los costados. Ah, brazos.
Yes, ajá.
So los brazos del sofá.
Exactly. O los que donde usted apoya sus brazos. Mm-hmm. Those are the armchairs. Todo lo que tenga para apoyar brazos son armchairs.
Sure.
Okay, very good. So in my house there are 4 armchairs. In my house. Okay. Mm-hmm. And you can say in my house there are 2, there are 3. But Carlos me preguntaba si dijéramos 10 sofas. Imagine. In a house, in one house, having 10 sofas is exaggerated. But imagine you have 10 sofas. So there are a lot of sofas if you don't want to mention the number. Is it clear?
Okay.
Clear.
Excellent. Very good. Okay. Tito, give me examples, please.
Okay, teacher. There is a computer.
Okay, a computer.
There is a telephone.
Telephone.
There is a kitchen.
Okay.
A kitchen. There is an AC. Aire acondicionado.
Oh, there is an AC. All right. AC. Very good. Yeah.
There is a picture.
Picture.
There is a fridge.
Oh, a fridge.
A fridge. There is a cinema.
In your house. Wow, very good. All right, very good. Okay. Todas están bien, Tito. All right. All your sentences are correct, but pronunciation. For example, this one is picture. This one will be like fridge.
Fridge.
Fridge. Fridge. Mm-hmm. Very good. Fridge. Okay. Very good. And okay. I need one more. A volunteer. El que quiera. Okay. Okay. Felicita. All right. Very good. Give me some examples, please.
There is a dog. There are two sofas.
Okay.
There is a television.
Television.
There are a lot of shoes. There are a lot of books. There are a lot of curtains.
Okay, okay, that's all. All right, there are a lot of... Okay, Felicita, what's the problem? What's the problem with this sentence and with this sentence? What's the problem? Or maybe someone else can help me.
Books.
Exactly. Books and
curtains.
Excellent, Felicita. Very good. Excellent. All right. Okay. Nice. Okay, good, good. Nice, nice. All right. So we're going to erase this. I'm going to stop the, I'm going to stop the share and we're going to go back to our slide. Now, the next thing we're going to do is, ahora vamos a tener un como práctica de esto, como un pequeño repaso, right? So here we have, this is like similar to the map that we had yesterday. But if you pay attention, I have different, how can I tell you? I have different
places
and the names of the streets are different. First and Second Avenue are the same. For example, Mercedes Street and Independence Street. And we have different places. For example, Natalie, can you tell me the places, the new places that we have? Okay, can you...
She's sleeping.
Yes, can you tell me the different places that we have? Read the names.
Swimming pool.
Mm-hmm.
French Academy.
Academy?
French Academy.
Yeah.
Music store.
Yes.
Supermarket.
Yes.
Black Pirate Barber Shop.
Okay, Black Pirate.
Black Pirate
Shop. El Pirata Barba Negra. Black Pirate Barber Shop. Disco Star.
Disco Store.
And shopping.
Shopping mall.
Okay. So today we're gonna practice. Yesterday we were practicing with on. So today I'm gonna give you more options. Les voy a dar más opciones. Okay. For example, we can use now on. What's the meaning of on, everybody?
Sobre.
Sobre or surface. All right. On the surface. Then we're gonna use in. Not in. We're gonna use across from.
Enfrente de.
Al otro lado de. Mm-hmm.
Ah, al otro lado.
Very good. Mm-hmm. Because enfrente de is in front of.
In front of.
Very good. And we're gonna use.
Between.
Okay, we're gonna use three more. Between.
Entre.
Exactly.
Very dos calles good. O dos avenidas.
Exactly. O dos lugares, Freya.
Ajá.
Oh, okay. So. Okay, very good. and we were listening, right?
Everything.
Yes. Ay, pobrecita la niña, quizás no mira a su papá todo el día y quiere verlo. Okay, very good. All right, so what we're gonna do is please take a picture with the new places because we're gonna practice with different places and different prepositions. On, across from, and between. All right, más adelante le voy a enseñar otras because we're gonna have more. All right, so do you have the picture?
Yes.
Yes.
Very good. Ahora sí ya nos pueden salir más oraciones, no solo, oh, yeah, I finished quickly. No. We can say more sentences. We can, for example, we can say French Academy is between some streets. Black Park Barbershop is across from, all right? You can, or on, we can use it like that. All right, so I'm gonna stop the share. And I have, Yesenia has joined in Blanqui. All right, very good. So we're gonna go to the breakout rooms. All right. And we're gonna have a group of three. Alonso, Blanqui, Tito, Grecia, Carlos, Francisco, Felicita. Excellent. Yeah, I like my groups. Okay, very good. All right, so we're gonna practice and bye-bye. Go and practice.
Estaba leyendo quizá la lista.
Ok.
Pero ¿verdad que solo somos las dos?
Yo creo que sí.
No va a ser que estemos ignorando a alguien, pero yo creo que no.
¿Me? Oh. No, don't worry. You are only with Helen. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yes.
Thank you.
Yeah. Okay, good.
Bueno, entonces.
Es un alisado, ok. Uh-huh. A la teacher le vamos a hacer el alisado.
Ah, ¡ay, no! No! I love my hair.
It's beautiful hair.
Thank you, yeah. It is growing, está creciendo, it is growing.
Yeah,
because I had my hair short. Okay, go ahead, practice. Let's practice. Good.
Okay.
Swimming pool is swimming pool is on Independence Street.
Oh, okay. Beautiful on the company. Swimming.
Mm-hmm. Swimming pool.
Surface es superficie.
Vaya. It is black pirate. How do you say?
Oh, okay. Bórrele el kiris. Solo diga, black pirate barbershop is. Porque is, cuando, porque el, si usted quiere poner it, para eso tiene Black Pirate Barbershop. Todo eso, si lo sustituimos, sería it. Entonces, si lo ponemos otra vez, estamos como diciendo dos veces la misma cosa. Very good. So, no vamos a decir, por ejemplo, Black Pirate Barbershop, it is. No, because or is Black Pirate Barbershop or it.
Pero ayer, ¿cómo decíamos en el ejemplo, profe?
Así decíamos. Black Pirate Barbershop is on the Second Avenue, or Black Pirate Barbershop is across from.
In this case, the Black Pirate Barbershop is between.
Excellent. Very good. Nice.
Between Independence
Street.
Teacher.
Yes.
We need help.
Okay, tell me.
A ver, no logré entender qué es lo que íbamos a hacer, estaba un poquito distraído.
lo que las oraciones que estábamos haciendo ayer, pero ahora vamos a agregar más palabras. Across from, for example, French Academy is across from Black Pirate Barbershop.
Okay.
Or supermarket, the supermarket is across from the swimming pool. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, okay. And you can say on, you can say
between.
Between. Yeah. So maybe to help Carla, cuando regresemos de los breakout rooms, voy a dar más tiempo. To help Carla, maybe you can type the sentences. Javier, okay. Please.
Yeah.
Please. Okay. Very Perfecto. Good. All right.
Gracias. Let's, thank you.
All right. Let's continue. All right. Let me see. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah, between French Academy or shopping mall.
Between Independence Street and Mercedes Street. Across from Black Fire Barbershop. Black Fire Barbershop. Y se acabó.
I'm gonna give you more time, but when we go back.
Hola.
Okay, everybody. Maybe you didn't finish, or did you finish?
Yes, no. Finish.
¿Quiénes no terminaron? Levanten la mano. ¿Cuántas oraciones me hicieron?
Two.
Oh, no. So we need more time and more practice. All right, very good. And Antonio Alonso, who were you working with?
Con Tito y Blanqui.
Ah, okay. So maybe what you can do is maybe you can type the sentences that you say. Can you do that, Alonso, from your phone?
No.
No.
I can't.
Okay. Tito, are you from the laptop? Tito, ¿está usted desde la laptop?
No, no.
Only Carlos, you
said laptop. Tito, yuhu, yuhu.
Yeah. Okay. All right, Alonso, you tell him. Okay. All right, I'm going to give you more time. Les voy a dar quizás unos 4 minutes more to do and to write sorry some sentences. Okay, bye-bye again. One more time. All right, one more time.
Face,
es que...
porque está sobre eso.
Es que shopping mall on Second Avenue.
Pero cuando voy a usar el...
Cuando usted le pregunta, mire, y usted conoce esa frase, así, váyase sobre la Gabriela Mistral. Algo así, le entiendo que quiere decir esto.
That's the way it is.
Ah. Uh-huh,
así es. Para mencionar ella, sobre qué calle.
Cabal. Entonces sería el on surface.
Oh, no. Es que surface es como el significado.
Superficie.
Ajá, la preposición es on. Solo eso vamos a usar. Uh-huh.
Ah, solo el on, el surface sí. No.
No, porque dice on igual surface. Uh-huh.
Ah, ya entendí, yes. Teacher.
Yeah. Okay, very good. So you
entonces digamos, Mire, yo le pregunto en inglés, vea, porque no sé ni cómo preguntar. Mire, Carlos, where ¿por is... dónde? Ah, ok, bye. Where is
Metrocentro.
Salvador del Mundo, por decirle.
Ok, ok.
¿Cómo me va a responder usted?
The Salvador el... del Mundo is on Roosevelt Avenue.
Excelente.
Ajá, cabal.
Very good.
Ah, pues ya entendí. On, el Surface no lo voy a ocupar,
no,
entonces.
No, don't use it.
Es que como nosotros sí hizo la traducción, por ejemplo, across al otro lado, between, entre, y on, puso su face, puso esta palabra en inglés.
Exactly.
Y yo, tuya. Ah, ok.
Yes.
Bueno, hoy pregúntame usted a mí, Carlos, para ver si yo puedo.
Where is? Mm-hmm.
Is on. Is on Independence Street. Okay, number two. Miss, sorry, yeah. Miss, one question.
Yes.
Al principio estábamos haciendo las oraciones, pero sin utilizar el there are. Entonces entramos en la duda si usamos.
No, lo usemos. No, don't use it.
Thank you. No, okay.
Don't use it right now.
Solamente okay. Sería Fresh Academy, across from Black Spirits Berber Soul.
Oh, French Academy is. Mm-hmm.
Is.
Exactly. Yeah, you need to mention is. It's like if you say está. Mm-hmm.
Is across from.
Exactly. It is across from.
Okay. Black pronunciation pirate.
Pirate. Sorry if you see me moving my neck. But I have a lot of pain.
Teacher.
Yes.
What do you say, carretera?
Highway.
Highway.
To hell. Mm-hmm. Highway, highway.
What is the difference in highway and freeway?
Ah, freeway tiene muchos más carriles, all right? It has a lot of lanes, and a highway can be only 4 lanes. But a freeway has like 12 lanes.
Okay.
Yes, very good, all right. Okay, so we're gonna practice. All right, we're gonna practice.
Okay.
Okay, so what we're gonna do right now is I'm gonna ask you a question and I'm gonna show you the question. The question will be, where is? And I'm gonna mention the place. For example, Carlos, where is French Academy?
The French Academy is between Independence Street and Mercedes Street.
Y si usted quiere, me puede decir on First Avenue.
On First Avenue.
Across from Black Pirate Barber Shop.
Black Pirate Barber
Shop. Exactly.
Across from.
No, no podemos, no nos quedamos solo con una, podemos decir del el punto, right? Very good.
Complete description.
Exactly. Yeah, of course. All right. Let me see. Javier, where is the shopping mall?
Shopping mall. The shopping mall is on Second Avenue. Across from Black Pride Barbershop.
Excellent, Javier. Very good. Nice. No, nice job. Oh. All right. And Noemi, where is Disco Bar? Disco Star. I'm sorry. Disco Star.
Disco Star is in front Music Store. It is on Mercedes Street.
Okay. Very good. All right, very good. Okay. In front of. Aunque en este mapa se mira pequeño, pero lo divide en calles. Entonces, mejor vamos a decir across from, all right?
Okay.
Allá, in front of sería, por ejemplo,
más cerca.
Más cerca. Very good. That is the word. Okay. Grecia Alonso, where is the swimming pool?
The swimming pool is on Independence Street or First Avenue, across from supermarket.
Excellent. Very good. Nice.
Wow.
Yeah, very good. Very pro.
Okay.
Okay, let me see. Pedro, are you there, Pedro? No, he's not there. Let me see. Ah, Pedro. All right, Pedro, where is the supermarket?
Supermarket is on the Independence Street, on the Second Avenue.
Okay, excellent.
Between Second Avenue and First Avenue.
Okay, we can say that. Yes, very good. Nice. Okay, excellent, everybody. Nice, nice. But we have to continue. All right, we have to continue because we have other things to do. Now we're gonna continue with the next activity, and is this. All right. Así como hicimos de trabajar con el vocabulary, ahora les voy a dar un lugar específico, ¿ok? So, they are 1, 2, 3, 4, they are 5 places. A park, a school, a restaurant,
restaurant,
a zoo, and a supermarket, Ok, I'm gonna mention, un lugar que no está ahí. Let me see, I'm gonna mention a hospital. Ok, ¿qué va a hacer con su compañero? You will describe the place using there is, there are, and you're gonna use the negative form. There isn't and there aren't any, or there are no. Lo voy a escribir para que se recuerde. So, the negative form, what is your negative form?
There aren't.
There isn't
from the singular, and for the plural?
There are not.
So you can say the negative form in two ways. Now, take a picture, please, because I'm gonna go to make the groups.
Yes.
Okay. Very good. Pero primero voy a pasar la lista, los que no estaban la primera vez. Soy la Noemí Córdoba de Valencia.
Present.
Ok, Carlita is here, Carlos is here, Yesenia Lourdes Magaña.
Present.
Jorge Alexander Reyes López.
Present.
Blanca Margarita Chávez Pérez.
Present.
Felicita estaba la primera vez, Grecia también, Helen. Yeah. Liceo Guadalupe Ramos. Not here. Julio Tito Orellana.
Present.
Okay. Giovanni Vladimir Escamilla, no. Francisco Javier, ya lo mencionamos. Pedro Antonio Hernández.
Present.
Okay. Wendy Pérez, not present. Giovanni Vladimir, not present. Ana Gladys has never been present. Mauricio, not present anymore. And Lisette, not present today. All right. Very good. Okay, so let me see, we're gonna make the groups para hacer esta actividad. Let me see, so vamos a ver cuántos somos. We can be in pairs. Okay, lo vamos a hacer en pareja. Sorry. ¿Por qué me los? No acepten nada ahorita, don't accept anything. Give me a second. Se unió alguien. Ah, no, aquí está. Ok. I'm gonna give you some minutes. Vamos a ver. Alonso Antonio, en Jorge Reyes, you will describe a school. All right?
Okay, that's cool.
Yes, Carlos Alberto Bautista, Jeff Bonilla, and Yesenia Magaña, you will describe a park. All right, very good. Si ustedes quieren empezar en un parque específico, está bien, no problem. Ok, Andrea, Natalie, and Carla, Noemi, ¿qué otras opciones teníamos, everybody? I don't remember.
A restaurant.
Ok, tell me the options, because I don't remember. Park.
Restaurant.
Oh. Restaurant.
Give me a second. Uh-huh. Park, school, restaurant. The school and the supermarket. Okay, very good.
Hospital.
Ah, no, ese lo dije ahorita solo como ejemplo. Uh-huh, okay. So, Carlos and Yesenia, a park.
Park.
Andrea, Natalie and Carla, Noemi, a restaurant. Piensen en un restaurante, puede ser específico o restaurantes en general. Todos comparten lo mismo. Hay mesas, hay sillas, hay ventanas, hay plantas, hay meseros. All right. Felicita en Pedro Antonio, you will describe the zoo. Hay un montón que decir. Hay bancas, hay árboles, hay animales, hay leones, hay elefantes, okay, etc. En Helen María en Noemí, the supermarket. Supermarket. Grecia y Ulises en Julio Tito, you will describe a restaurant. En Blanca Margarita en Francisco Javier, you will describe a park. Okay? Okay, so I'm gonna give you some minutes so you can do it. Bye-bye. Go and practice. All right, very good. Carlita.
Vamos a anotar o solo las vamos a decir.
No, tenemos que anotarlo, porque creería yo que luego lo vamos a leer. Entonces, podríamos comenzar poniendo el nombre, ¿vale? Por ejemplo.
Of this. Entonces, ¿qué más hay en una escuela? There is a...
No, porque no solo es un grado, right? Entonces podríamos decir, there are teachers.
There are teachers. ¿Cómo se dice cancha?
Oh, there is a basketball court.
Oh, okay. There is a basketball.
There is a basketball court. Okay, go ahead. Continue.
Okay, thank you. Oh.
There are some.
There are a lot of plants,
o sea, varias plantas. There are a lot of plants. There are elephants. There are elephants. Okay. Elephants. There are a monkey.
There are monkeys.
Monkeys. There are monkeys.
There are monkeys.
Uh-huh, there sin, are elephants.
Sin la. Mm-hmm, sin la.
There are.
Exactly. There are elephants. Or there are
elephants.
Solo un elefante sería
elefante.
Okay, gracias.
Yes,
there is elephant.
Okay. Yeah, excellent. Very good.
Elephants. There are a elephant, si son varios.
There are sin la.
Ah, okay.
si quiere decir que hay dos, there are two elephants.
Elephant.
Pero si solo hay uno, is an elephant. Eso fuera como si fuéramos un safari. There are a lot of elephants.
There are a lot of plants. Plants, ¿verdad?
Porque excellent. Hay plants. There are a lot of plants.
There are...
How do you say
there are a lot of...
Birds.
Parts. ¿Cómo se llama? Pájaros.
Birds.
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 Mm-hmm.
Birds.
There are a lot of...
Birds.
A lot of birds.
Mm-hmm.
Birds.
Mm-hmm.
There are a lot of podría ser
tortugas. Yes, tortugas.
Yeah, tortugas.
There are a lot of fish.
There are a lot of
fishes.
Pescado.
Fishes, uh-huh. Fishes. Yes. Peces sería.
Uh-huh.
Ya pescado es.
Peces.
There are a lot of lions, there are a lot of
tigers. Uh-huh.
A lot of they are
you can use negative sentences too. There aren't any. Or there are no, all right? That's what you can say, okay?
Okay.
Water sources, porque fuentes es sources, y agua, water sources. No sé si así se dice.
Water sources?
Ajá. ¿Qué más hay en un parque, usted? Bueno, voy a buscar qué hay en un parque.
Parejitas, come on.
Es que no sé qué más hay. Y fuentes, sí está bien, así como lo hemos puesto. Water sources,
yeah. Or you can say fountain.
¿Cómo?
Fountain, fountain. Yeah, there are fountains. Yeah, we can say that.
Okay.
De ahí podemos poner.
Sorry, Javier.
Yep.
In number two, there are benches. There are playing areas. Mm-hmm. Areas de juego.
Benches.
Playing benches. Exactly. Very good.
Playing areas.
Playing areas. Mm-hmm. Playing areas.
Okay, there are bears, there are peoples, there are...
Sin la S, people ya está en plural.
People es plural siempre.
Exactly, la persona. Sí.
Uh-huh. Okay, there are any computers?
Computers. And
there are motels.
Oh, TV, TVs. Quiero ver qué más hay en un parque. A eso iba, la teacher me distrajo. Uy.
Oiga, teacher.
Sorry, what happened? Se escuchaba lo que dije. Javier, did you listen what I was saying? No, right?
No, nothing, teacher, nothing.
De verdad, se me escuchó.
Don't worry.
No, my microphone was mute.
Don't worry.
Pedro Antonio me escuchó decir las chancletas, niño. Yeah, okay. Now, let me see. Can you please tell me your descriptions? Maybe, Alonso, you were working with Jorge Reyes, right? So you were going to describe. Tell me the place you were going to describe and some sentences, please.
Okay. Describe a school. There are a lot of desks.
Desks. Mm-hmm.
Okay. Okay. There is a security agent. Ahora continue, Jorge.
Okay, very good.
Help me.
Help, or you can say, si usted le quiere decir que continúe, dígale, go on. Go on, Jorge. On.
Go on, Jorge. Mute.
In the school, there are football players. There is a director. There are
teachers.
Football. Ahí sí tenía una pregunta. Con los equipos. Por ejemplo, there are football players. Pero si me quiero referir al conjunto, sí sería a football team. O tengo que usar el there are.
Okay, give me a second. Vaya, primero vamos a corregir algo. There are football player. Remember that we need to always use plural. So you say football players.
Players.
Don't forget to mention the plural way, all right? There are football players. When you talk about teams, you say there is a team. Because one team has, o se toma como conjunto. Ahora, si hay dos, you say there are two teams. Y si es un intramuros, for example, there are a lot of teams. Okay? Yeah, okay. That's what we can say. There are football players, there is a team because it is one. And two teams are a lot of teams. Okay?
Okay.
All right, Jorge, continue, please.
Thank you.
Oh, you finished?
Yes.
All right, very good. Okay. Volunteers? Only one, please. Only one. No. Ah, thank you, Yesenia.
Yesenia.
All right, Yesenia will help.
Nosotros nos tocó con Carlos el parque.
Okay.
The park.
Sorry, I'm laughing because look at Jorge. Se ha dado cuenta, mira. He's eating a banana.
Okay,
Yesenia, go ahead.
Okay, in the park. Ay, no sé cómo se dice, espérame, ya me trabé. There are
trees. Okay.
In the park, there are flowers.
Excellent.
Ooh.
In the park, there are play mechanic play.
Oh, okay. I'm gonna help you with that.
All right, I'm going to show you my whiteboard. Es donde está el deslizadero y todo eso, ¿verdad?
No, juegos mecánicos pensamos que era eso.
Vaya, a eso se le llama playground. Pero vamos a decir, there is a playground.
Ah, ok, entonces lo tenemos mal. Is, ¿verdad?
There is a playground. Sí, el playground es la del deslizadero, the slides. All right, swings, los columpios, the swings, okay. Very good.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, Carlos?
But we think about the place mechanic is, for example, Chicago.
So you say the mechanical games?
Sí.
Yes.
Yeah, you can say mechanical games.
It's not play mechanics.
No. Mechanical games. Yeah.
Como juego mecánico.
Yeah. Y les voy a enseñar una palabra nueva. ¿Se acuerdan de este?
Sube y baja.
Ajá. Sí. In English is seesaw. All right. The seesaw. Seesaw. El sube y baja. Seesaw. No, up and down. All right. Ay, you don't say that. You thought about that. No, you say, when I was a little boy, I used to play in the up and down. No, it is seesaw. Up and down. Yeah, it's like, es como decir, esto está malo. Oigan. Mira, ¿y tú cada cuánto te bañas? Ah, un día sí y un día no. Some people say, one day yes and one day no. No, that is not correct. Usted dice, por ejemplo, I take a shower every other day.
Okay.
Okay. Esa frase, every other day, means un día sí y un día no. But it is not possible to say, one day yes and one day no. Okay, so it is similar to sube y baja. Okay, very good. Okay, Yesenia, continue. Continue, please.
And now, my partner Carlos presentation.
Ah, okay, very good.
Okay.
Esa estuvo buena.
Sí, muy buena. That was good. Because it was only in English. Okay, Carlos.
In the park, there aren't pools. In the park, there aren't ATMs. In the park, there is a soccer field. In the park, there aren't wild animals.
Okay, Carlos, thank you very much. All right. Because of the time, por el tiempo, vamos a continuar. We're gonna go on. All right, we're gonna go on. And let me check. We're gonna go on with this. Sorry. But I think that we have to go to, give me a second, please. Okay. Oh, sorry, I was opening the book, but I didn't want you to see my secrets. We're gonna go to page number 45 on the manual. Okay, this is what we're gonna do right now. This is something very, very easy. Now here we have, vamos a hacer un poquito de repaso. Here we have an employee's information card, all right? So, name Mauricio Quintanilla. ¿Cómo sería la pregunta?
What did your name?
Exactly. What's your name? That would be the question. Mauricio Quintanilla. What about for office or main phone number? What is the question?
What is your telephone number?
Exactly. So you say, what's your phone number? All right. We can say that.
What's your phone number?
Excellent. What's your phone number? What about for the next one? Workplace. What would be the question? ¿Cómo sería la pregunta?
Where do you work?
Excellent. Very good. All right. The next question will be, where do you work? ¿Dónde trabajas? Very good. Where do you work? The next question, address.
What is your address?
Excellent. What's your address? Cuando practiquemos, nosotros solo vamos a decir la que hemos aprendido. Okay. Job position. That would be,
what do you
What do you,
what do, you do
for teaching? We can say, what do you do or what's for your job position? Job.
Okay.
And the answer is, I am a manager or whatever. Department. ¿Cómo preguntaríamos? En qué departamento trabajas? Esta pregunta es nueva.
Which?
It is. ¿Quién dijo? ¿Quién dijo?
No.
Which? Okay, so we say, which department? Which department do you work at?
At.
Which department do you work at? Okay, which department do you work at? Hey, ¿cómo sería la pregunta para el ID?
What is your ID?
What's your ID number? Very good, Alonso.
Okay.
Alonso, right?
Yes.
What's your ID number? Okay. So, nosotros vamos a ir a practicar esto, aunque hay alguna información que no la digamos real, all right? Solo digámosla por práctica, you invent. For example, your ID number, your telephone number, your address, all right? Try to say different information to practice. Entonces, vamos a hacer varias preguntas. Let me see. What are the questions we're gonna ask? First question?
Teacher.
Yes. Yesenia?
Yo tengo una duda. Yo sé que ya lo vimos, pero me he agarrado llave ahorita. Mm-hmm. What do you do?
¿Qué haces?
Pero mm-hmm. ¿qué haces en el ahorita? De ahorita estoy recibiendo clases. ¿O qué
no,
haces
eso ya, en tu eso vida? Eso ya es present continuous. Eso ya sería what are you doing?
¿Qué haces en la vida normal?
Ajá, what do you, es que puede significar dos cosas. ¿Qué haces? What do you do? Y si le queremos poner every day, es que haces todos los días. Pero para preguntar por la profesión, decimos what do you do? That is the question.
Ya. Okay. Ya tengo esa duda. Mejor preguntar.
All right. Very good. No, that's okay. Perfect. Okay, so the first question is what's your name? What's your phone number? Where do you work? What's your address? What do you do? What's your job position? What's your ID number? And which department do you work at? Is clear?
Which department? Yes.
Which department do you work at? Okay. So please take a picture porque vamos a ir a practicar. We're gonna practice this.
Okay.
All right. Very good. So I'm gonna stop the share. And we're gonna practice. Nos vamos a entrevistar. All right. Very good. Okay, so try to give as much information as possible. Bye-bye, everybody. And we're gonna practice, yes.
Teacher, no estoy invitado.
¿No le cayó, Pedro?
No.
Vaya, lo voy a poner en otro room y después lo mando al que tiene que estar. ¿Ok?
De acuerdo.
Ok. Number 6. All right.
Where do you work?
I work in FC Auditores. And you, Felicita?
Where do you work?
Where do you work? In the office, auditor accounts.
Oh, okay, okay.
FC.
Very nice.
What is your address?
Oh, my address. Okay. My address, the company I work for is Second Avenue North in San Miguel.
Okay.
And you, Felicita? What's your address, Felicita?
What's your address?
Yes.
The word is Second Avenue. Four.
Oh.
Second okay. Avenue. To San Miguel. What do you do?
Really? Okay.
What do you do, job position?
My position. Okay. My position is auditor, auxiliary auditor.
Okay.
Yeah.
Which department do you work?
Okay.
Finished.
Yes.
Finished. Ya se entrevistaron los dos.
No, Andrea no. Tiene que.
Okay, okay, very good.
Okay.
Okay, ask the questions.
Okay, Tito. Bueno. What's your name?
My
Espérenme, que aquí lo tenemos. La última era Ale. Ya lo vio Ale. Which department do you work?
Sí.
Pero me tienen que contestar manager. Ah, no va. Crédito y cobro. ¿Cómo se dice crédito y cobro?
No sé, pero...
Créditos y cobros.
Yo me apoyo en el traductor. Hay veces.
That's okay, that's okay.
Credit and charge, así. Credits and charge.
Exactly.
Credits
and charge.
Ah, vaya, así se dice.
Vaya, dele.
Dele. Esperen que se me perdió la pantallita. Aquí está. Which, I know, la última, ¿cómo íbamos a decir? La última, what's your ID number?
Ese es el Luis, ¿verdad?
Ajá, cabal. Algo así.
Oh, but don't say your ID number in the video, on the video, because...
You invent.
Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. ¿Yo cómo se dice?
Ah, dash.
Dash.
Mm-hmm.
My turn, Jorge. Pregúnteme a mí.
A contra. Which department?
He's saying accountant.
Hey, Carlos, he works. He works at, oh yeah, está bien, his phone number. A phone le falta la H. Le toma captura de pantalla cuando lo termine de ocupar porque lo voy a pedirle que lo proyecte.
Va.
All your classmates, porque me gusta cómo lo están haciendo. All right, go ahead.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay, good. Continue. Very good. Yes, you are doing a good job. All right, go ahead.
Okay.
Yes.
¿Cómo se dice es cansado el trabajo?
Oh, my job is okay. You can have two ways. You can say my job is exhausting, or you can say my job is tiring.
Tiring.
Yes.
Mejor exhaustivo suena más fácil. Exhausting. My job is ¿cómo se dice?
Exhausting. Yeah, like that. Exhausting.
Ah, pues. My job is exhausting.
Really, Yesenia?
Uy, sí. Siento que hay días.
But ya no. Do you take vitamins or something?
Ah, tal vez.
Yeah.
Maybe.
Yeah, necessary. Oh. No, a todos.
A todos.
Okay, yes. Okay, everybody. Cada quien estaba trabajando de forma muy bonita. For example, Grecia en Felicita, cuando trabajan juntas, se proponen solo hablar en inglés. Y aquí la tengo en video. Sorry.
Okay.
Hey, Felicita en Grecia. Yes, porque ese es el objetivo, okay? That is the objective. We don't speak perfect English, but we are learning. Y todo lo que aprendemos tenemos que ocuparlo, okay? So that's why when I listened to Grecia and Felicita practicing, it was very, very interesting. Carlos and Pedro estaban trabajando a su manera. Carlos, can you please share the picture? Para enseñarles cómo lo estaban haciendo ellos, how they were doing it. Okay, yo no le dije que escribieran la información del otro compañero, solo que se preguntaran, pero ellos lo estaban haciendo así. And what I really liked was, quiero ver si puedo usar tools, let me see. No. ¿Pueden ver el puntero? Can you see my mouse?
No.
No, okay.
No.
Well, but if you pay attention in Carlos' picture, ellos estaban escribiendo la pregunta, right? They were typing the question and the answer, but from the partner. So what's your name? His name is Pedro Antonio. I mean, Pedro dijo, my name is Pedro Antonio, but they were typing, Carlos was typing the third person singular. And what I really liked, ¿cómo hizo eso, Antonio?
Ahí está el lapicito.
Request. Annotate. Ah, sí, aquí está. Uh-huh. Yeah. Okay, you're good. Yeah, I got it. Okay, so necesito lo que necesito. No está.
Teacher, pero yo estoy viendo ahí que donde le dice, what's your address? La dirección no es la misma de donde uno vive.
Ajá, él solo no se quiso complicar.
Pero es correcto hacer eso.
Yes, I mean, what's your address?
También.
I live in San Salvador, all right. Or if you want to be, la respuesta correcta sería la dirección, okay? For example, mm-hmm. What's your address? Oh, I live in Mexico. Well, I live in Escalón neighborhood. All right, house number 44, etc. Okay, very good. That would be the correct answer.
Yeah.
Hoy sí pueden ver el puntero. Can you see the...
No.
No. Oh, my God. Let me see. Y aquí sí.
No.
Oh, my Lord. All right, well, the thing is that... And now?
En ver opción, oh, yeah.
Ah,
sí, ya está.
El relajo quería esta cosa. All right, so, if you pay attention, y algo que por eso le dije yo a él que lo compartiera, don't forget that if you talk about third person singular, you're gonna use the verb in third person singular. He works, right? He lives, He is, all right? That's, you don't have to forget that. Okay. So thank you, Carlos. I'm gonna stop your picture. Yes, very good. Ellos lo trabajaron así. They were working on that way. Okay, so right now we're gonna continue. And I'm gonna, wait, let me see. Okay, I'm gonna show you the next step porque ya casi nos queda poco tiempo. All right, so we're gonna work with the next thing and I'm gonna show you some prepositions of place. Estas son las que vamos a ocupar ahora. Y un par más, all right? But I want you to take a look at this. So here we have other prepositions that we can use. For example, Javier, can you help me please read the prepositions? Which prepositions we have?
Position of place, along, in front of, next to, behind, across from, between.
All right, thank you, Javier. So here we're gonna say behind. It's like if you say behind. All right, behind. This will be like behind the pronunciation. And this one will be like between. All right, very good, between. This will be like the pronunciation. Behind, between. Clear?
Behind blue eyes.
Very good. Between. Exactly, behind, between, que son las que más cuestan to pronounce. Okay, so I'm gonna show you, if you want, you can take pictures or whatever you want. Behind, and I'm gonna show you some examples, all right? I'm gonna show you some examples para que los entiendan mejor. Okay, so the first example, can you please, Antonio? Uy, ¿quién está ahí raspando?
Minuta.
Minuta.
All right, yes.
Oh, la cama.
Yes, all right.
Okay, examples.
Okay, Antonio.
Go along the street.
Okay, what do you think means go along this street? What's the meaning of go along this street? Can you tell me?
A lo largo de esta calle.
Exactly. That is the meaning. Vaya a lo largo. Go along.
Vaya a lo largo por esta calle.
Exactly.
Sí.
Go along this street.
Okay.
And the church is in front of the bakery. Okay.
Cuando uno dice, digamos, al final de esta calle, final street.
Go along this street to the end. Podemos decir to the end. O go along, go to the end. Go along this street to the end. Yeah, that would be like the word. Go along this street to the end. Now, the next one, the supermarket is in front of the mall.
El supermercado está frente del centro comercial.
So, vaya, imagínese, este es un oh, here. So, here is the supermarket. And here is the mall. No, vamos a ver, sorry. En el mismo bloque, digamos que están las dos cosas. No uno separado del otro. Entonces sería así. Este no. Sería el supermarket. Espéreme.
No, pero no podía ser enfrente, sí. Teacher.
Sí, ahorita lo vamos a corregir.
Contigo, sería, tal vez.
Sería así. Digamos que aquí es el mall. Ajá, ahí. Entonces... Aquí sí.
Y ahí no está
pero,
enfrente.
Pero tendría que ser a cross front porque tendría que haber un pasillo de...
No. Aquí sí no, porque están en el mismo bloque.
Ah,
fuera
okay.
A cross front si los dividiera una calle.
Ah, solo que lo divida, solo que lo divida una calle, nada más.
Exacto. Okay. Aquí, digamos que están en el mismo bloque, por eso.
Aunque
que
lo divide una calle ahí, pero es interna dentro del mismo bloque.
Exactly. Muy bien. Super, le vamos a poner. Exacto. No es como la gran diferencia, right?
Sí,
it is not. It is not like. Sorry, the distance is not a lot. So here we can say. The supermarket is in front of the mall.
Okay. Oh, the mall. Sí.
So here is the mall, the super, and here is the mall. The next one is the drugstore. Ah, esta está fácil.
La farmacia.
The drugstore.
Después del cine.
No.
No, contiguo.
Exactly. Next to.
Ah, contiguo.
Así. A la par de.
No. A la par de. Very good. So this would be like drugstore.
¿Cómo es lo correcto?
Next to es
contiguo o a la par.
A la par.
Okay.
Voy a anotar.
Okay, very good. Yeah. And here cinema. All right. So we say the drugstore is next to the cinema. Okay. That would be the drugstore is next to the cinema. Okay. Now the barber shop.
It's across from the park.
Exactly. So the barber shop will be here. Like barber shop.
Cruzando.
And here is the park. And okay. Here we have a street.
Mm-hmm.
Is it clear? Okay. All right, here yes. We...
Buena dibujante.
Sí.
Sorry.
Yo creo que está estudiando arquitectura.
Ay,
o
Dios,
algo
mire,
por estilo.
Arquitectura y mire las líneas para dónde va.
No, como
no,
los edificios modernos son así hoy.
Ah, all right.
Con curvas y todo, ¿verdad?
Arte no importa, moderno. Teacher, okay. Está bien.
Yeah. Okay. So we say the barber shop. Thank you, Antonio. So the barber shop is across from the park. Okay, very good. So this will be like that. This is the difference, Tito.
Okay.
Okay, very good. Now, the school is between First Avenue and Second Avenue.
Okay.
All right. So between, I will represent between like this. All right. So I will represent.
Entre la avenida. Entre la primera avenida y la segunda avenida.
Exactly. So imagínese, esta es First Avenue and Second Avenue. Between. All right. Very good. So this will be the school. Right? The school. And the next, the last one is the park is behind the hospital.
The hospital.
Exactly. So imagine.
El parque está atrás del hospital. Está.
Exactly. So imagine this is the hospital, all right? Se los estoy haciendo con toda la paciencia para que podamos, so we can understand. So this is the hospital, okay? And imagine behind the hospital, we have a park. Okay, very good. So we have a park and this is our park. Okay. Mm-hmm. So are the prepositions clear?
Yes.
Are the prepositions clear, or do you have any question?
Yes, yes.
Behind is atrás o qué?
Oh, behind is atrás.
Atrás de.
Mm-hmm. Very good. So behind, for example, porque algunos no viven acá en San Salvador. But here in San Salvador, pero ya han venido acá, ¿verdad? No.
Sí.
No, okay, no venido. Conozco yo.
Pajero.
¿Conocen
el hotel? No sé cómo se llama hoy, pero el Intercontinental.
Yeah, por metro. Yeah.
Exactly. Yes. So behind the hotel, there are a lot of bars.
Ah, sí.
Ah, sí.
Yes,
sí,
or no?
Así dicen.
Ah,
sí, se llama rapidito.
Así dicen. Okay, very good. So please, if you want, take a picture. All right, take. Jan, you get the picture?
Yes.
Y que la cosa es, ¿cómo se llama?
Okay.
Ay, nada, me he quedado.
Uy, ¿cómo? Estamos escuchando ¿cómo? Los secretos ahí. Okay, we were listening to that. Por eso es que no hay que dejar el microphone open porque podemos enterarnos de todos los secrets. Okay, very good. So I'm gonna go to the next. And here we have some information. Okay, very good. Aquí tenemos dos que no les puse, ¿eh? All right, I didn't show
teacher, you. Perdón, a long, ¿qué dijo que era? Largo.
A lo largo de.
A lo largo.
A lo largo de.
Exactly, okay. Uy. Sorry, all right. Now, here we have estas que no la vimos. Okay, we didn't see past and under.
Debajo.
Okay. Past es, for example, pasar de largo.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, for example, you have Pizza Hut here. You have Pizza Hut here. Super Selectos here. And Burger King here. Entonces, ¿quiere ir al Burger King? Viene alguien y le dice, okay, go along this street.
Past.
Go past Pizza Hut.
Pasando Pizza Hut.
Supermarket, ok. Yes, es como pasar
de.
De. And under means debajo. For example, if it is a bridge, si es un puente, if mm-hmm. it is a bridge, you can say under, o si estamos en un edificio de varios pisos.
Okay.
For example,
debajo de la segunda planta.
Exacto, no. Muy bien. Very good.
Sería under.
Under, yes. Under the second floor.
Okay.
Second floor. Mm-hmm. Second
under floor. The basement.
Under the basement. Very good. Debajo mm-hmm. del
parking under, lot.
Under the parking lot, etc. All right.
Under the, ¿cómo se dice? Puerta, mesa. Under the table.
Under the table. Uh-huh. Okay.
Abajo de la mesa.
Now, vamos a completar esas oraciones. We're going to complete these sentences porque para la última actividad necesito un poquito de tiempo. So, number one, the sports palace. Ah, pero tenemos que ver un mapa. We have to see a map. Uy, aquí vamos a estar algo complicado, pero vamos a ver. Okay, so, sentence number one says, page number 39. Vamos a ver.
Pueden ponerlos a la par.
Este mapa. Okay. All right, for example, my God, Yesenia. For example, let me see. I know. All right, for example, está cansada. Everybody, I think. Okay, number one.
Sorry.
The sports palace is the bank. Y aquí está el sports palace. ¿Dónde está el sports palace? Y dice,
aquí.
The sports palace.
The sports palace.
The sports palace.
Está enfrente de... Digamos.
Ajá. So,
pero se dice
in front of
across from. Okay, vaya, vamos a hacer una cosa. Tómele una foto a ese mapa, please. Take a picture to the map. Y esa respuesta me la va a escribir en la plataforma, on the platform.
Take care.
Ah, ok.
Donde solo poquitos me participan, solo 4, 3, y necesito everybody. I need everybody to participate, at least the last days. Vaya, tenemos ahí esa foto.
¿Es una tarea?
Yes, eso me lo van a poner en el...
Las preguntitas.
En la plataforma,
eso.
Solo la respuesta. One, this, okay. Two, this, three, this, four, this. Okay, only that. Okay. So take a picture, please, from the exercise.
Okay.
It will be exercise number 5.
Yeah.
You have it?
Oh. Yeah.
Oh, no.
Okay,
I have
Javier.
It.
You have it. All right. So when you have it, let me know.
It's okay.
Okay. Very good. All right. Now, ¿qué es la actividad final que vamos a hacer? What is the last activity we're going to do? Well, the last activity we're going to do is this. We will have a real conversation. Hoy vamos a tratar de hacer una real conversation. And you will describe your office, okay? So, student A is gonna ask the other student to describe the office. For example, Javier trabaja conmigo. Como, hi, Javier, how are you?
Hi, teacher. Fine, thank you.
Hey, yeah. Javier, where do you work?
Where do you work?
Yes.
I work at IT Solution.
Okay, and can you describe your office?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, okay. So, student A pregunta. Student B describes the office. Oh, in my office there are five employees. There are two tables. There are etc. Is it clear?
Okay.
Okay. Very good. Está difícil? Is it difficult?
Social.
No, come on. Vamos a imaginarnos algo real. All right. So, yes, les voy a dar unos minutitos porque ahora we have something to do after the class. So, let me see. Yeah, escapation. All right. Let me see. Okay, here. I'm going to give you some minutes to do this. Okay, bye-bye.
Bye.
Sorry. Okay, go and accept the invitation. Thank you very much.
No me dormí, teacher. Se me descargó el teléfono.
Okay, la voy a mandar a un grupo. Espérame, quiero ver. I will send you to... Number one, okay?
Porque no la veo. Pero en lo que decía, en la captura, en realidad, solo debía habernos dicho, solamente decía que teníamos que hacer la descripción de nuestra oficina, ¿verdad? Usted es el estudiante B y yo soy el A, por ejemplo. Entonces, yo hago las preguntas y usted hace la respuesta. ¿Ya?
Bye.
Entonces no había otra instrucción. Yeah. Ok. Go.
Ok.
Pedro.
You can begin like, hi Pedro, how are you? Excuse me, where do you work? Describe your office. Ok.
Okay. Thank you, miss.
All right. Aquí nos vamos a rebuscar. Okay, podamos, all right.
The rebuscation.
Ajá, pero la respuesta, ahí es donde vamos a practicar lo que hemos estudiado. There is and then there are. Okay?
Okay.
Good.
Hi, Pedro. Nice to meet you.
Restaurant is
No, la siguiente es the city hall is the church and book world. The city hall.
The city hall is. Ponga el mapa, quiero ver.
Vamos a ver el mapa. City hall.
Sorry to interrupt. Ahorita lo que íbamos a hacer era una conversación. A conversation.
A conversation. Estábamos haciendo la tarea.
Y nosotros haciendo la tarea.
No, we're gonna, yeah, ajá, very good. No me hagas trampa, don't play tricks.
Oh, okay.
solo pueden preguntar, ¿vale? Como son tres, solo pregúntense. Okay, Helen, describe your office. Oh, in my office, there is this, there are these, okay?
Yes.
All right, very good. Go ahead.
Okay.
Printer.
Teacher.
I'm sorry, there because it is very printers.
Printer.
Printer. You have a question.
There are printers. There are printers. Okay.
Javier, you have a question. ¿Qué
más? No. Solo es que está...
Okay. Soplation.
Yeah.
A esta acción se le llama... Vaya, ¿cómo se llama el aparato que nos da aire?
Fan.
A esto se le llama fanning.
Fanning.
Uh-huh. I am abanicar. Fanning myself. Uh-huh. Como abanicar. I am fanning myself. Right now. Uh-huh.
¿Y cómo se dice? What's the meaning you have... Tienes calor.
Oh, are you or do you feel hot?
You have.
Do you feel?
Do you feel hot?
Yeah, porque are you hot se puede entender de diferentes maneras.
Yeah.
Pero no de la mala, sino que puede ser, por ejemplo, are you hot? Like, are you sexy or something like that? Hot is a synonym of sexy for Americans.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay, continue.
Okay. Vaya. ¿Qué más? There are printers, dijimos, right? Printers. Archivo, ¿cómo es?
Hello, teacher, me quedé sola.
Sorry, se quedó sola. ¿Con quién estaba? Sorry?
Con Tito.
Ah, with Tito. And, okay, very good.
Creo que tuvo problemas con el internet.
Ah. Sí, porque no lo veo.
Uh-huh.
Sí. Okay. Well, everybody, we're going to finish here. So don't forget to go to the platform and type your. ¿Qué pasó, Alonso? Alonso.
¿Qué estábamos haciendo trampa?
you were playing tricks on me. Okay, so thank you very much, everybody. Vamos a aprovechar las últimas dos clases que nos quedan, que son tomorrow and Friday. Así que no falten. El viernes, vamos, el viernes sí necesito que todos estén porque vamos a llenar una nota de satisfacción.
Okay.
Excellent. Yo les explico más. I will give you some information.
Excellent.
Have a celebration.
Yeah. Bye. Bye.
Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye.